Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about the different ways we can add our 3D content to the scene. Of course, we could use the standard 3D's Max tools and manage without the project manager, but this is hardly the most convenient and ergonomic procedure. Here, see for yourself. If I only have one screen, I'll need to first minimize the 3D's Max window, then find the model in the Explorer, copy the path to the model, go back to the 3D's Max window, and then find the appropriate function to import the model. Since such cross-platform formats as OBJ, FBX, and the same can only be added to the scene via import, while the standard 3D's Max format is added to the scene via the Merge function. I wouldn't call this optimal at all, considering how much it takes to perform all those mouse movements when navigating through the Windows Explorer and 3D's Max menus. If, on top of that, our content is scattered across several networks or local drives, searching for the desired model may turn into a quest. Project Manager will let us gather the whole library together, even if it is fragmented and located on different drives. An important point, whatever the case, you will need to organize your library manually. There is no such thing as miracles, so take some time and set up your libraries. You can begin by simply adding the folders with the necessary content into Project Manager. Later, without interrupting your workflow, you will be able to organize your content directly in Project Manager by creating new categories and distributing your content among them in a meaningful way. But I digress. Apart from cataloging, the plugin also allows us to quickly add a 3D model to the scene without leaving the 3D's Max workspace. When working the one monitor, we simply minimize the plugin window. If we have a second monitor, we can put the window there and thus make the process of adding the model to the scene even easier. Now, let's take a look at various ways of adding models to the scene with the Project Manager tool. Drag and drop option. First, we find the model we need in the catalog and drag it into any viewport in 3D's Max. Immediately after placing the model into the scene, the following options appear. If we hold down the Shift key, the model stops moving with the cursor, which allows us to change our settings in the Place and Paint panel. And if we hold down the Shift and Control, we can freely rotate the model along the Z-axis. By holding down the Control and clicking the left mouse button, we can rotate the model 90 degrees counterclockwise. The ALT and left mouse button combination lets us turn the model 90 degrees clockwise. A right click stops the placement operation altogether. Right here at the top, we can see the Place and Paint panel, which can be customized for our particular needs. Let's take a look at what this panel lets us do. The Place and Paint panel can help us customize the process of placing the model into the scene. We can adjust these settings both beforehand and when we've already begun importing our model. Place on menu settings. The Home Grid Only option lets us place the model on the default grid in the viewport. Selected Objects option places the model on any selected object in the scene. Note that if we do not select those objects before we start importing, we are prompted to do so on the fly. In the Scene Objects mode, we can place our model on the surface of any object in the scene. It is important to understand and appreciate the complexity of your scene. If the scene contains lots of objects, this mode can cause viewport performance to slow down because the imported object will try to hook itself to every geometry in the scene. A better choice for complex scenes is definitely to pinpoint the objects using the Selected Objects or Home Grid options. Before adding a model to the scene, we can set the alignment mode of the model, which is done in the Align Mode group. The default mode here is to normal. The added object is aligned with the normal of the object it is placed on. Align to normal. is suitable for most cases. But let's say I am planting trees on a tilted surface. This mold will produce an incorrect result. In such case, it is better to use the smart mode. In the smart mode, a model can remain vertical when placed on a tilted surface. This mode suits for planting trees on mountainsides, putting paintings or sconces on the walls, and other similar situations. The Clone menu lets us choose a copying mode for the model, instance, or copy. Right next to it, there is a Stop Play button, which is used to stop the painting process. Why would we do that? When we stop painting, we can add or remove some objects for copying and placement. This is done in the Paint Objects dialog box, which becomes active after we click the Stop button. When we are done changing the list of paint objects, we can resume painting by clicking the Play button. The Place Mode menu lets us set the painting mode. The default mode for painting objects into the scene is by mouse click. This mode is suitable for pinpoint placement of objects. In case we need to actually paint with objects, we should select the Use 3D's Max Paint Settings mode. By holding the left mouse button, we can literally paint with geometry. The right mouse button click stops the painting process. And now we can assign new paint objects and continue. The spacing option sets the distance between the cloned objects. When the Display as Box parameter is on, the object is added to the scene as a box, which is important for speeding up viewpoint performance when painting with high-density mesh models. Enabling the Paint on Painted Objects mode lets us paint objects onto the surfaces of their own clones within the same session. For example, when this option is turned off, the added object ignores its clone and interacts only with the objects in the scene. If, however, we enable the option, the object can be placed in the surface of its own clone. Replace selection. This is not an importing function per se, but what it does is add a model to the scene through replacement. This function has several options. Clicking the All Instances button will replace all objects in the scene that are instance copies of the selected object by an object chosen from the library. Selected Only will replace only the selected item. And now for the additional replacement conditions. If the Keep Selection box is checked, the object being replaced remains in the scene. Uncheck this box and the replaced object will be deleted. Reset Pivot resets the pivot of the imported model. drag and drop plus shift. Holding down the shift key while dragging the model into the viewport will summon the standard 3D's Max menu, which we usually see when dragging the model from Windows Explorer. Double-click. When the exact location of an added object in the scene doesn't matter, the fastest import option would be a double-click. One double-click, and the model is instantly in the scene. A key point here is that when using the Project Manager for import, you do not need to worry about the original format of the model you add. Whether your model is a 3DS or an FBX, every import option in the Project Manager will work for you. Naturally, not all functions will be available for improving third-party formats. Let's take the 3DS format. It can't be loaded into the scene via XREF, but it does not matter much. What is important is that you don't have to care about which format your model is stored in and how you import it. Just drag it into the viewport or add it to the scene with a double click. Apart from that, Project Manager lets us render such models interactively. This especially applies to order collections, where models are often presented in OBJ or 3DS formats. The Merge option can be reached by right-clicking on the model. Here I am offered two menus. The first option is right for the cases when I need to only add a part of the model, or if I need to insert an animated model while preserving its hierarchy. The second option adds the model to the scene as an external link, that is, as an XREF scene, including the dummy bonus, which allows the controlling of the position of the XREF scene. The animated models can be imported by all the options available in Project Manager. Drag and drop plus shift, double click, or via the Merge with Default 3D's Max Dialog menu. No redundant mouse manipulations needed. Everything happens automatically and with no unpleasant surprises. You should mind the settings in the Settings section, though, and if need be, specify the necessary import options. The default settings work just fine in 99% of the cases. In the Settings section, we can adjust some special import options. The settings of the Exclude group let us exclude objects from import by a certain class. Quick default options exclude spleens, frozen and hidden objects, and cameras. We can set additional exceptions and make them into a present in the Exclude Objects by Class menu. This means that we save the important settings with the list of necessary exceptions. In the Model Merge Options menu, we can specify to convert our model into a proxy when merging. Of course, we can also use the existing proxy file for this model. We can also choose to import our model as an RXEF file. Sometimes the materials in the scene and the imported models may have the same names. We can avoid duplicating materials by choosing suitable import conditions for the materials in the Material Merge Options menu, such as Use Scene Material, Use Merge Material, Auto Rename Merge Material. That's all for now. Fast renderings to you all. We'll see you.